another episode of Bollywood This Week. Friends, the movie show review today is none other than Mammootty's film Puthan Panam. Well, friends, Puthan Panam is the movie straight after the super success of The Great Father. So, friends, before going to this movie, I'll give you 3 points to keep in mind before going for this movie. First, this movie is not The Great Father. So, don't go with the hangover of Mammootty from The Great Father. Two, if you do not go with the hangover of The Great Father, you will not come out, you know, disappointed. You will come out pretty pleased with this movie. And number three, this is not a regular Malayalam movie. This looks like a Tamil cinema. The direction, the style, everything is very Tamil cinema-like, not at all like a Malayalam movie. So friends, what is Puthan Panam all about? Let's see in this review with me, Amir Ansari. And after watching the review, please subscribe to my channel. Puthan Panam has been directed by Ranjit, has been produced by Three Colors Cinema. Cinema stars obviously Mammootty. It stars Mammu Koya. Fantastic! I mean, Mammu Koya, who plays the assistant of Mammootty in this movie, is fabulous in the movie. The kid, who's played by Swaraj Gramika, is fantastic in the movie. The small boy is pretty nice in the movie. Ineya, who plays the mother of the small kid, is also very nice in the movie. The supporting star cast includes Siddiq, Baiju, Indrans, and Niranjana, Anoop, Harish, and everyone have done a fantastic job in the movie. But the only letdown in this movie is its story. And A, it has been promoted as the movie based on demonetization. Well, let me tell you friends, apart from the news that Mr. Modi, Narendra Modi, declares that the demonetization is going to take place, nothing in this movie is minutely also connected to demonetization. So don't go into this movie thinking that this is going to be a movie based on demonetization, because it is not at all based on demonetization. Second factor keeping in mind is that the story revolves just around a gun. Well friends, and the third thing is that why do Malayalam cinema does not release its movies at the same time it releases in Kerala? I mean, this movie has released on a Wednesday in Kerala and has released today. That is a Friday all over India, and that too it releases the movie at show timings which are really, really, you know, not convenient for people to watch the movie. They are releasing show movies at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the evening, you know, almost the day is over. So we have to review this movie on a Saturday. So friends, what is the story all about? Let's see in the movie. The story begins when, you know, our heroine Ineya, you know, takes a small kid and is running from her house. Why is she running from her house? Because in 2006 in Tamil Nadu, husband has been stabbed to death, and now she has been forced to take a small kid and run out from Tamil Nadu. Well friends, she runs and goes into a train. A man follows them in the train, helps them to come to Ernakulam. Yes friends, they come to Ernakulam, and in Ernakulam that man, you know, lets them to stay in their house, but obviously he has bad intentions to keep him in the house and obviously wants to have sex with the mother of the small kid. Well, let me tell you one more thing in this movie friends, the movie has been granted an A certificate. A certificate means that people above 18 can watch this movie. Well, when The Great Father deserved an A certificate, they gave it a UA certificate, and in this movie, Puthan Panam, there is nothing to give it an A certificate. Not a murder, not a sleazy scene. I don't know why it has been given an A certificate. So friends, the movie, you know, moves forward, and now that man comes completely drunk in the night and wants to have sex obviously with the mother. But he is a rowdy cheater, and the police comes and arrests that man. So now the mother and the son have been left in the house completely all to themselves. Well friends, the story moves 10 years forward. And now we are shown that the same mother, Ineya, you know, now is working for a female commissioner. Well friends, one more, you know, point I want to mention in this movie is that on the poster of this movie, you know, a female cop has been shown, you know, with a police uniform, and in the movie there is no role of hers. It's a 2-minute role in the movie, and she's been, like, you know, standing next to Mammootty. So friends, our youngster Swaraj and her mother Ineya living together. Now Swaraj has become this big boy and now started going to school, and now we are shown that he's dancing in school, enjoying his life, and every day after school he goes to a junkyard. Well, that junkyard, you know, has all used electronic items, you know, thrown away goods, and that he sells to some antique fellow who develops some articles with that. So friends, the story moves forward. Now the day comes when Modi announces demonetization. Yes, when Modi announced demonetization and a very certain gang, you know, the movie is not at all clearly focused on where the money has come from, whose the money is, and a certain gang lord, Wakil, calls up Mammootty. You know, Mammootty's character also has not been shown, nothing has been shown from where he's come from. Directly we are shown that he's this big don and he's sitting on a big sofa with a dhoti and he gives an interview. Well, let me tell you one thing, again full marks to the stylist of Mammootty. He is looking fantastic and this man has lost a lot of weight. I mean, he's looking so fit and slim, better than the great father, trust me friends. So he got this call that they have to, you know, do some gambling of the money, turn it into white, and for that Mammootty, you know, gets up, goes into the temple and takes out his favorite pistol, does the puja, keeps it in a red bag. A lot of dialogues are in the Kannada in this movie, and the scene when Mammootty goes to his son and telling, yes, I'm going for a trip, is very nice. So Mammootty with his gang is set to go to Kerala to meet a certain minister about this money laundering. Well, what is a money laundering? It is a suspense of the movie. For that you have to see the movie. Now he reaches the house of the minister and a confrontation takes place. During the confrontation, one of the members of Mammootty's gang suddenly, to his surprise, takes the gun out and, you know, points it at the minister and accidentally shoots the minister. So friends, the minister has been shot now and hell breaks loose. Now Mammootty tells them to clear the field, change the gun. They exchange the gun of the minister with the real gun with which Mammootty had shot the minister. Now they are on the run, but he is scared. He can see a checkpost of police there. That is why Mammootty, you know, takes the gun and throws it away in a junkyard. Yes, the same junkyard where our, you know, small hero Swaraj goes every day after school. Well, he goes to the checkpost, and for the police not to get any doubt and suspicion, Mammootty tells them, oh, I'm carrying some, you know, black money, I want to surrender. Please, sorry, I'm very sorry. And he goes into the jail and surrenders and declares all the amount and spends the whole night in the station. Well friends, in the morning when all of them come out of the police station and go to find the gun, to the surprise, the gun is not there. They cannot find the gun and the gun is missing. But now the investigations have begun and the police have come to know that the bullet fired to the minister and the gun in the minister's hand both are very different. So friends, Mammootty gets very scared and now he is, you know, very hell-bent to find the gun. But when they go to find the gun, they find a beggar who is wearing the cap, is a cap in which the gun has been kept. He's wearing like a Santa Claus hat and he tells, I am Santa. Well, Mammootty tells, where is the gun? But he does not tell anything. Well friends, the story moves now to the mother and the son. The mother and the son are now being again disturbed by the same man who had left them 10 years ago. He has come back into their life and now is giving a very tough time to the mother and son. So friends, the story moves forward. Now the gun has been found by Master Swaraj. Yes friends, one day Master Swaraj goes into the junkyard and finds that gun over there and now he has the gun. So the man is coming to hit the mother and the son, and to the man's surprise and even to the audience surprise, the boy removes the gun and he shoots that man. Yes friends, he shoots that old uncle and on his leg and he runs away. Well, after that the uncle runs to the hospital. Those scenes are pretty nice. I really liked how they made the movie, you know, especially pre-interval scenes. The man runs to the hospital, you know, they come, they open the wound, how they remove the bullet, very nicely shown, and doctor says you have to wait here, I'll go and complain to the police, this is a police case. Well, he tells, no, he runs away from the hospital. Well, that's when the police comes to know in the forensic report that the bullet shot to the uncle and the bullet shot to the minister are the same bullets. Well friends, the film, you know, sets the tone very nicely at that point of time, but till then you have lost all your hopes because you expected a great father to be there in this movie, but disappointingly there was not a great father. There was nothing about demonetization. All you get, you know, in your plate of food is a gun. The film is all about a freaking gun. That's why the audience gets very disappointed. You know, in the interval point, I could hear the people, you know, cursing that the movie, what is this movie? Why we have come to the movie? Because the movie was houseful, friends. People had even purchased tickets in black and they were completely disappointed when they come to this movie about a gun. But keeping all those things aside, let's concentrate on the story of the movie. The story is not at all that bad, friends. So, friends, the interval point comes when, you know, they come to know that the forensic minister shot as the same bullet and the uncle shot as the same bullet. Now they have to find the gun. Mammootty has to find the gun, and that kid Swaraj, you know, removes the gun, points it to the air, and Mammootty is standing on a high rise Interval, fantastic. Till the Interval, the film is very nice according to me, but not according to the audience. But after Interval, there is one scene which is so funny. Censor board, you know, obviously when we smoke, a certain character smokes on screen or drinks alcohol, there comes a statutory warning that smoking is not allowed, drinking is not allowed. But in this is a very funny scene. I mean, censor board has really gone mad. There is one scene when a person is driving a bike without an helmet, and there is a statutory warning, please do not ride without helmet, please wear helmet for safety reasons, on the screen. I mean, the audience gets distracted, dude, don't do all this. So friends, after that, the four members of the Mammootty gang, you know, are caught by the police on suspicion. Why? It's a secret of the movie. They get caught by suspicion, they are tortured in jail, they are, you know, put into jail, and the judge tells that we have to find evidence against them because it's a hi-fi case, minister is involved, so I cannot grant him bail. Mammootty changes colors, changes pants, comes in his trademark dhoti and t-shirt, and now is telling Vakil to please come and bail them out. But the judge is not granting them bail, and they are getting repeatedly trashed, you know, inside the jail. But then, you know, another track comes into the movie, unnecessary track. I don't think the track should have been there in the movie. A couple, there is a certain, you know, chicken store in Kerala. It is like KFC, Chick King. A person works in Chick King, falls in love with a girl, and they are two are a couple. They are shown in the movie, two young people, and now they have been harassed by an Eve teaser. A guy on the bike is teasing that girl, and you know, that is why to take revenge, they come and contact our hero Master Swaraj, and he goes with a gun and, you know, accidentally points that gun on that boy. Very moment Mammootty arrives to the scene, you know, along with his assistant Mamu Koya, and finds his gun in the hand of the boy, and now he wants the gun. Well, after that, the scenes between the boy and Mammootty are very nice. How Mammootty tries to take that gun very nicely, very calmly. They become bail vendors, they offer him tea, they offer him money, they offer him a car ride. But that boy says, no, I don't want to sell my gun. I will not sell my gun. The scene when Mammootty gets a dream, you know, the boy is selling a gun for 500 rupees is very nice. And the second half of the movie is pretty nice based on the relationship of how Mammootty wants to acquire the gun. Well, friends, the gun is not found, and now the uncle who has been shot tells the police that nobody else shot me, but that small boy shot me. The police comes into the area. Mammootty is standing reading newspaper there. There's a music band, funny music band playing there. The police comes to investigate the case, and boy tells, I have not shot him. Police tells, we have to search the house. The whole area tells that this man, you're believing this man, he's a bloody rowdy, why do you believe him? Police goes to search, they find nothing, and the background music by Achu Rajamani in the second half, friends. Seriously, hip-hop, R&B stuff, very nice, very nicely shown. So now, the uncle with the bullet can cause problems. Mammootty comes to know this, and the scene where they go and kidnap that uncle, push him into the car along with the rickshaw fellow also, very nice, very Malayalam cinema type. There are some elements which are Malayalam cinema type, but they have throttled on a part, you know, part where Tamil cinema always throttles. That is what Ranjith has done in this movie, which will shoo away very, you know, large amount of Malayalam audiences. So friends, after that, what happens? Does Mammootty find the gun? Do they come to know who has killed the real minister? What is the role of demoralization? Well, the end is very predictable. Your guess is as good as mine. I will not tell you the end, but let me tell you, friends, I was supposed to give this movie just 2 out of 5 stars, but in the climax, what Mammootty has done on screen has forced me to give this movie 3 stars, because in the climax, Mammootty has done some fantastic action scenes. I mean, the entry, how he comes out from this car, the slow motion, all the Great Father fans will come and, you know, get the paisa also. I got my paisa also because the last scene. Well, friends, Mammootty has done a somersault in the end. He's given an air shot punch. He's given a double kick to the villain. He's looking like, you know, obviously does not look like Dulkar Salman's father. He's looking like his brother in this movie. So young, so effervescent. Seriously, and the climax is very nice. And in the climax, how he's sitting on a boat, that won me over. So despite the negative points, you know, a very badly scripted story and promoting the film on the subjects of demonetization, still I give, you know, the film Puthan Panam of Mammootty 1, 2, 3 film. It's an okay movie, very average film, but every Mammootty fan should watch this movie. So friends, coming to the work of this movie, Mammootty is fantastic. His clothes, full marks to Nair, I have found his name out. Nair is a costume guy for Mammootty. Fantastic costumes. The boy Swaraj Gramika is very nice, a very good find in this movie. Dances pretty well in the movie. Inaya the Maja is very gorgeous, very concerning on screen. Siddiq, Beju, Indrans especially has done a fantastic job in this movie. Director Ranjit should have, you know, stuck to his guns in making a Malayalam movie and not a Malayalam movie which is, you know, very Tamil in nature. All in all, it is a very average movie. Keeping the flaws aside, all Mammootty fans should go for this movie. So friends, if you like this review, please like our channel and subscribe to our channel. After subscribing, please press the bell button for notifications. We come every Friday if the movie releases outside India with a new Malayalam movie review. So friends, keep watching Bollywood This Week. I can subscribe to my channel.